Hello, Vital Sign. Today we're going to talk about the conormal product of graphs, also known as the OR product of graphs. The conormal product of graphs is an operation on graphs that takes as its input two undirected simple graphs G and H, and outputs a new undirected simple graph, known as the conormal product of G and H. The vertex set of the conormal product graph is the Cartesian product of the vertex sets of the factor graphs. In other words, each vertex in the conormal product graph corresponds to and is labeled with a pair of vertices from graphs G and H, where the left entry in each pair is a vertex from graph G, and the right entry in each pair is a vertex from graph H. How are the vertices in the conormal product connected? They are connected according to two adjacency rules. The first rule for connecting vertices in the conormal product is this. Two conormal product graph vertices, UV and U' V', are adjacent if their left entries are adjacent vertices in the left graph, G. The second adjacency rule is this. Two conormal product graph vertices, UV and U' V', are adjacent if their right entries are adjacent vertices in the right graph, H. We can merge the adjacency rules into one statement, which is why this product is also known as the OR product. The statement is, two vertices in the conormal product, each representing a pair of vertices from the factor graphs G and H, are adjacent if their left entries are adjacent vertices in the left graph, or, and that's an inclusive OR, their right entries are adjacent vertices in the right graph. For example, say we have two vertices, A1 and C3, in the conormal product of graphs G and H shown here, whose left entries are adjacent in G and whose right entries are adjacent in H. Then they'll still connect, as we're using an inclusive OR in the statement of the adjacency rules. Notice that this implies that any two vertices adjacent in the tensor product of two graphs are also adjacent in the conormal product of those two graphs. That's because the OR in the statement of the conormal product adjacency rules allows us to include the case where both left and right entries are adjacent in their respective graphs, which is precisely the condition for adjacency in a tensor product of graphs. Now that we've gone over the basics and connected the OR product to a more popular product, the tensor product, let's work through a few examples. What is the conormal product of these two graphs, G and H? Well, the vertex set is the Cartesian product of the vertex sets of the factor graphs. Next, let's connect the vertices one at a time. By the first adjacency condition, vertex A1 connects to all vertices with left entry, or letter, adjacent to vertex A in graph G. Since vertices B and D are adjacent to vertex A in graph G, then in the conormal product, vertex A1 connects to all vertices with left entry, B or D. By the second adjacency condition, vertex A1 connects to all vertices with right entry, or number, adjacent to vertex 1 in graph H. Since vertex 2 is adjacent to vertex 1 in graph H, then in the conormal product, vertex A1 connects to all vertices with right entry, 2. Note that some of these connections we already had because they met the first adjacency condition. But we only include one edge between pairs of vertices because we're creating a simple graph. This will be the case going forward as well. Moving on, by the first adjacency rule, vertex A2 connects to all vertices with left entry adjacent to vertex A in graph G. As we covered for vertex A1, that means that vertex A2 will connect to all vertices whose letter is B or D. By the second adjacency rule, vertex A2 connects to all vertices whose right entries are adjacent vertices to vertex 2 in graph H. Since vertex 1 is adjacent to vertex 2 in graph H, vertex A2 is adjacent to all vertices whose number is 1. On to vertex B1. By the first adjacency rule, B1 will connect to vertices A1, A2, C1, and C2, as their left entries are adjacent to vertex B in graph G. By the second adjacency rule, B1 will connect to vertices A2, B2, C2, and D2, as their right entries are adjacent to vertex 1 in graph H. On to vertex B2. By the first adjacency condition, B2 will be adjacent to A1, A2, C1, and C2, as their left entries are adjacent vertices to vertex B in graph G. By the second adjacency rule, B2 will connect to vertices A1, B1, C1, and D1, as their right entries are adjacent vertices to vertex 2 in graph H. Halfway there. By the first adjacency rule, vertex C1 will connect to vertices B1, B2, D1, and D2. By the second adjacency rule, C1 will connect to vertices A2, B2, C2, and D2. Three more to go now. By the first adjacency rule, vertex C2 will connect to vertices B1, B2, D1, and D2. And by the second adjacency rule, C2 will connect to vertices A1, B1, C1, and D1. Just two more to go. By the first adjacency rule, vertex D1 connects to A1, A2, C1, and C2. And by the second adjacency rule, D1 connects to vertices A2, B2, C2, and D2. Finally, the first adjacency rule tells us to connect vertex D2 to A1, A2, C1, and C2. The second adjacency rule tells us to connect vertex D2 to A1, B1, C1, and D1. This is our final result. Let's do two more examples. What is the conormal product of these two graphs, G and H? Feel free to pause the video and work it out yourself first. First, we'll need the vertex set of the product. That would be the Cartesian product of the vertex sets of G and H, which is this. Now, let me show you a quicker way to go through the adjacency calculations. Just look at the left entries of the vertices. Ignore the right entries for now. For each edge in the left graph, find all pairs of conormal product vertices whose left entries are the endpoints of that edge, and then connect them. So if vertex A is adjacent to vertex B in graph G, then connect each conormal product vertex starting with letter A to all of those starting with letter B. Repeat for all remaining edges in G. In this case, that just leaves BC. Now that we've finished that, all of the adjacencies resulting from our first adjacency rule are on our graph. The only ones remaining are those that come from our second adjacency rule. So now, ignore the left entries and focus on the right entries of the conormal product vertices. Connect all pairs of conormal product vertices whose right entries are adjacent pairs of vertices in graph H. There we go. That is the conormal product of G and H. As our final example, what's the conormal product of these two graphs, G and H? Again, feel free to pause and solve it yourself. Well, here is our vertex set of the conormal product. And then here are the adjacencies that come from the first adjacency condition. That is, those between vertices with left entries adjacent in graph G. Since there are no adjacencies in graph H, we're done. We don't need to use the second adjacency rule. To summarize, the conormal product is a binary graph operation that takes as its input undirected simple graphs and outputs an undirected simple graph with vertex set equal to the Cartesian product of the factor graph's vertex sets. Two vertices in the conormal product are adjacent if either their left or their right entries are adjacent in their respective factor graphs. One observation that we can make about the conormal product is that it generally results in a graph with many more edges than some of your more conventional graph products by nature of the inclusivity of the OR operation used in its adjacency conditions. That's it for this video. In future videos, we're going to look at some fascinating properties of the conormal product operation, so stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment if you liked the video. Have a great day.